Then we will now listen to the story of our four young professors who will achieve their second dream in their field of research. First, please welcome with big hand Professor Park Kae-won.
Hello, I am Park Kae-won from Mechanical Engineering, studying robotics. I wish to explore with you how the robot technology is going to develop and how it is going to change mobility of the future. With continued advancement of robot hardware and software technology, there will be robotics in the not-too-distant future that will exceed human motor and cognitive abilities. First, robotic hardware will develop in various areas such as artificial muscles that are supple yet strong, artificial skin that is tactile and can sense temperature, and skeletons that are made lighter with better material technology, which will make the robot not just human-like but superhuman with greater agility and awareness. Next, in software, artificial intelligence and control technology will develop beyond the human motor and cognitive abilities to equip the robot with intelligence that will allow it to perform complex tasks. So these robots of the future will perform tasks that are too dangerous for humans, like in industrial disaster relief, space exploration, and military areas. Hopefully, the industrial accident rate will go down to zero with robots handling all the dangerous work. And mobility in the future will be quite different. No more cars, to be replaced by omnipurpose unmanned Kaistram that is shared by everyone. We can move people or goods from A to B anywhere in the world without traffic congestion. And VR technology that combines robotics with AI will remove spatial barriers for humankind. We can be educated through digital avatars by accessing robots without physical barriers, interact with others, even go on vacation or conduct scientific experiments. This will mean a true artificial human mobility. Enabling new robotics also requires research into new materials. And now, regarding this, Professor Yeom Ji-hyun will tell us more. Good morning, this is Yeom Ji-hyun from Material Engineering. In materials research, the next 50 years will bring about innovation at a scale smaller than the nano. It is the new material technology that controls the state of electrons by adjusting the atomic array. The electrons that determine the property of materials have unique orientation through their rotation and revolution. If we apply orientation called chirality to the atomic array, we can enhance the material's property or create completely new properties. Then we could develop new materials like Kaisteel that is light but has strong physical properties. Such material will no doubt be immensely helpful in realizing the kind of robots envisioned by Professor Park Kae-won. Kaistronic material with such chirality can also be used for next-generation information computing. There is growing interest in big data in this fourth industrial revolution with various applications. Not only that, individuals are generating huge amounts of data, such as video. And with such data being shared over social network platforms, use of data and memory are growing exponentially. Now, one problem here is the power consumption necessitated by data processing. To run one data center requires 6 thermal power plants, and the associated issues of energy and environment will become even worse. Today, energy efficiency is quite low because electrons process and compute data as they physically move the circuits, which produces heat and wastes power. But Kaispin, based on spin wave, can be a new option. Spintronics, studied by several professors of KAIST, can be realized through the KAISTronics material with chirality. With the atomic array with chiral orientation, the electron's spin can be adjusted to enable ultra-low power operation, and the spin pulses can move long distances with higher efficiency. New materials will be crucial in addressing environmental and human problems for the next 50 years by letting us overcome the limitations of physical and electron properties. Now, in a nearer future, we will go beyond AI to the post-AI era. Now, Professor Shin Ki-jung, can you tell us how AI will change our lives? Good morning. This is Shin Ki-jung from AI Graduate School. Humans have opened up the era of AI by training AI in the past 50 years. The next 50 years will be about AI educating humans. AI will develop on its own through interactions with students and will find the most effective and efficient pedagogy. It will move away from existing barriers of subjects or departments and provide customized learning for individuals' interests and aptitude and help them unleash their utmost potential. Such change in education paradigm is an extension of AI Tutor, one of the research projects in KAIST. With the help of AI, humankind will absorb enormous amounts of knowledge quickly, leading to more knowledge being generated. This virtuous cycle will allow us to overcome our intellectual limitations, and it will bring us closer to the superhuman era. And I also wish to focus on KAIST's role in the future that will be determined by quantum computing. Digital transformation of the past 50 years has altered many parts of our lives. Next 50 years, we'll see quantum transformation, where quantum computing will seep into every corner of our lives. In other words, quantum computing will go beyond the development stage, moving more into the application stage. In the computer system area, KAIST is already leading the world, and we are also now leading the development in quantum computing, in programming language, operation system, computer security, and also we have the compiler technology that can automatically translate classic programs into quantum programs, which will allow the use of quantum computing for everyone. And this will also help with the forecast and also end traffic congestion and develop new drugs. Now then, Professor Zhu, can you tell us about the bioscience in the future that will be further advancing through AI? Hello everyone, I am Ju Young-seok from Medical Science Graduate School. Now, how is medical science going to change in the future? Now, so far, medical science and bioscience have been quite different than the traditional engineering. Rather than the strict theories that we see in math or physics, it was mostly empirical and based on experiments. But then now, in the future, I would say that it is going to be more about experiments. Now, if we also think about all the different animals that are being sacrificed in the experiments, we also have the rituals to soothe the animals that have been used for labs. So, of course, it does not seem compatible between KAIST and the lab animals. Now, what we see is that there are huge changes with the genetics, big data, AI, and robots. And if they continue, then I would say that the medical science and the bioscience are going to be completely different 50 years later. They will be completely digitalized. So in the next 50 years, we will be able to accurately predict the reactions from the human body, so the digital cells or the digital organs, so we are going to have the digital twins that will allow us to have the experiments utilizing these digital devices. Now, in the medical and the bioscience, as long as we have innovative ideas, then we will be able to put them into everyday lives very quickly. So then the digital scientists will turn into researchers. So then for the medical students in the next 20, 30 years, we'll look back to these days when we experiment on labs as the old traditional days. And we will continue to march forward so that we will be able to realize such days. And they say that the life is about birth and aging, disease and dying. And now this is also going to change, meaning that the aging and diseases are also going to be reduced. And we will also find customized genetic information, and also the innovative early diagnosis will allow low-cost, high-efficient medical system. For example, cancers, which is also a big problem, we will be able to have early diagnosis of the cancers, and also the cancers can be effectively treated much more quickly, meaning that there will be fewer terminally ill patients. And also the anti-aging and also even the reverse aging study that are underway in KAIST, if they continue to develop, I believe that that would also help enable happier and longer lives for everyone. So far we have talked about the robotic engineering, new materials, AI and bioengineering that will be realized in the next 100 years by KAIST. And I hope for your continued interest and encouragement for KAIST as it marches.